Hello, hello, hello. Hello, Japanese name. Alright, so. Seems like. K Japanese way. Seems like. I just got done going through horrible things, as you recall. Yeah, I remember. Abraham Lincoln Jr., right here, went through garbage to solve these crimes. So. He discovered there was some, if I remember properly, there was some backstabbing going on within this piece. There was all kind of bad things happening here. It's just a matter of figuring out who the worst bad guy is. And so, yeah, what is that language? K, what way? Japanese, Chinese, Korean? Alright, here we go. I have all new. What are my clues here? I should have all these clues hooked up now. LB was left behind. Okay, hold on, hold on. We're gonna figure the case out right now. Oh, okay, Chinese Mandarin. All right, here we go. We're gonna go through all the clues and break this mess down and come to the truth of the matter. I've gone through garbage and back. I won't say hell and back because you don't get out of hell, you know what I'm saying? But I will say I've gone through garbage and back. Here we go. Boom. The chosen one. Bernard Marley truly believes that he is a chosen one to do the curse's bidding. Bernard Marley is afraid of the curse and is trying to defend himself from it. He cannot be the chosen one. Let's read about Bernard Marley for a second here, shall we? Who's Bernard Marley again? Characters. Okay, Bernard Marley is not yet 45 years old of age. He is the foundry director and a member of the archaeological club. He is negligent and most likely lives alone. Bernard is a superstitious man, as indicated by the many amulets upon his person. It is clear that he spends a great deal of time seated as. All right, so he's a very superstitious person. He might just believe he is a holy person. I have a hard time with that yet. I'm gonna believe he's still fearful, Marley. I'll go with that for now. All right. So then, the next thing to do, the son is innocent. Yeah, I don't believe a little child, did all this stuff. You gotta be strong. Yeah, the son's innocent. I can't believe the son did that. Sorry, I have a hard time with that. Other collections. Yeah, I still believe he could have sold anything he wanted to sell. Testimonies. Yeah, that one's straight. Albeit lies. Albeit could only build a model of the fountain if he had managed to gain his entry. It wasn't necessary for Albeit to enter the fair in order to get it. He used his imagination. Oh boy. Since Sherlock uses imagination, why couldn't he use imagination? Now. This is a tricky one. I mean, I use my imagination, so he could use his imagination. No revenge. Albeit blames the expedition members for his fate. He seeks revenge and might adopt the curse to the end. Albeit believes that he was punished by the curse. I believe that. I think he might. I think he believes he's punished by the curse. Sir Charles is unaware of the existence of the curse. No, he's aware of the curse. Everybody's aware of the curse. That's dumb. Still, nothing's being helped here, as you can see. Nothing's being linked here. False statement. Sir Charles saw the statue of Tutankhamun run away. Sir Charles didn't see the running statue. He's either lying. He saw the running statue. Clear. Nothing's happening here. Automaton. The club statue of Tutankhamun was an automaton. It's not possible to build an automaton. Yes, it was an automaton. We saw it work. But look. There is no links being made. I am wrong about something here. So, let's try different things then. We'll see what clicks. Let's pretend the sun is guilty somehow. Nope, doesn't help us. Let's believe Bernard Marley is the chosen one. Doesn't help us. Let's just try different things. Well, nothing is linking here. Nothing is linking. Man, what the? Okay, well. Okay. We're gonna try different things here. Try different things. There we go. Something formed, as you can see. So what is this conclusion? The person who kills Zacharias has sufficient strength to make a powerful and accurate throw. That's if the automaton was no automaton. But we know there was an automaton. We know this. We saw it happening. But whatever, that's what it says. Okay, we'll keep figuring things out. This is why this game is hard, okay? The game is not easy at all. Oh, boom. So, this one concludes, and Sir Charles is guilty. But I had this conclusion already before. Yeah. This is the old conclusion I had. This conclusion. It doesn't make much sense. Because he had money. Yeah. Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. This one doesn't fit. That one does not work for me. So. No. Does not work. There was an automaton. Sorry, we saw that. It was programmed by somebody. You can program that method. They step into a certain spot, and it shoots. Hold on. I remember correctly. Anything to say, buddy?
A murder at my club. What a disaster for our reputation.
If I remember correctly, on the ground here. Yeah. The leaves on the ground make noises, which would activate, I think, that to shoot. This is not easy. See? There are a large amount of leaves on a bowling green near the body. It seems as if the murderer may have placed them there intentionally. Okay? The leaves make noise, boom! The thing fires off. Let's see here. It's gotta be an off of the town, sorry. I tried it base here. But that leads to this. Can't change that. Am I to believe the curse is real? That would be very un-Sherlock Holmes, but let's give it a shot. Oh no, it won't even change. Yeah, it's just too many things that are just not working out here. Enough to talk to is the question. No, everything's done. Everything. Everything is done. This is the old-fashioned way. I'm going to take every fact there is and compare with every other fact and see what pops up. What are we going to do? Because the only thing that pops up is stupid. The only thing that pops up is dumb. You know what I'm saying, Cassandra? Federer is skipping US, the Olympics and the US Open. He doesn't want to go down to Brazil and get the freaking virus. That's what he doesn't want.
What should we do next, Holmes?
I don't know, Watson. Help me out, bro. Man. All right, here we go. We're gonna do the old-fashioned way, okay? Old-fashioned way. We're going through every fact that we have and breaking it down bit by bit. Okay? That's what we're going to do. All right, so we'll begin with the automaton idea. This, I believe it was an automaton. Alright? Now we're gonna change every other fact there is except for this one. Here we go. Let's see what happens. Thank you. All right, so nothing changed that way. Okay, now. Yeah, see, that whole theory. You gotta be a strong person. All right, let's change this back. All right, and then we're going to, let's see, let's change this this way. And then change every other fact, let's see. Interesting how that disappeared. Okay. Nothing still. Oh my goodness. Okay. Next thing we need to do then is change this fact and change every other thing. This is insane. Nothing's popping up. Okay, so it's interesting. Whether the curse is real or not, does that change this thing here? Okay. Yeah. Whether it's something's not clicking here. Two facts that are not coinciding properly, linking together properly. Okay, let's keep going. Let's keep trying this thing. This will go here. Everything else will change. I'm trying everything here, ignoring nothing. Think Sir Charles is guilty? That's the only conclusion I have so far. That's the only one I have. But I had that from the very beginning. See? And that seems to be totally not how the game should play. Why did I go through all the mess that I went through if, you know... I know this much. If it's red, it's wrong. That much I know. See, right now they're all blue. And yet.
blinking right.
Yeah, exactly. Small kits, something small went off of that rooftop. Saw that happening. Wow, I mean, I found every clue in the case. That's the funny part, nothing new. There's nothing new. This case has messed me up, I tell ya. Now we confirmed it. That is true. That has to be true. What? Yeah, this mission is tough. Alright, we're gonna try this then. This seems to be the only one I'm not quite getting right. Let's get this wrong and see what happens, huh? I mean, wow, I don't know how many of these things. Wow, but nothing else really factors into this. Correct. This doesn't make any sense. Look at this. This makes no sense. This makes no sense whatsoever. Because we proved that there was a running statue. But you know what? Let's pretend. Let's pretend that. See what happens, okay? Here we go. This is totally wrong. Let's see what happens.
So I believe that it's time to pass on the leadership of your club to someone else.
I don't understand.
You were charged with the murder of Zacharias Greystoke. You murdered him for money and to further your career.
What? This is an outrage. I have powerful connections. You will regret this.
No way. No way. how do I go back? No. So yeah, that one I can't accept. That's a horrible ending. And it's a horrible ending. Horrible, horrible ending. Stupid, there's no drama, makes no sense. It ignores most of the clues that we had. Horrible, horrible. What am I getting incorrect? Why can I not draw another conclusion? What is wrong with my logical skills? What is wrong with me? What is wrong with me? Nope, that's incorrect. Oh. That definitely happened. We saw her running away. Guaranteed. Broke off, we have proof evidence of this. So Charles did not do it. Does Sir Charles know about the curse? Hold on. Yeah, that's why he's like, he's superstitious. Is he aware of the curse, actually? Wait, was he even partly... Hold on. Yeah. I think, if anything, albeit wants revenge, what happened to him. I'm gonna go with that. Let's see if we can prove albeit being guilty here. So. I find difficult, he's unaware though, but I'll be definitely a liar. Not sell that, makes no sense. He's definitely scared. We didn't see his son, did he? We didn't see Albiot's son. Oh, man. This has got to be it. Revenge. I believe this is revenge. Or his body being messed up. There's a photograph of the sun, but we didn't see the sun, did we? I didn't see this now. Where's LB at right now? Maybe it's house.
It's not here.
Hey, I'm gonna go to his house.
It's not here.
Why can't I go through? Seriously?
This should be the right place. Our man might be here.
Okay, that makes no sense, but okay.
That isn't our man.
You said mum. How British of you. You sure you weren't born in England or an English property and got moved to America? You sure about that? I mean, you gotta tell me. We're by ourselves here. Just tell me. Tell me! You were born in some kind of English protectorate and you're moved here. Just keep it real.
It's not here.
I think it's true. You're born either in England or a British home colony somewhere. And you got and you kind of like made your way over here. Yep.
Remembering how I obtained my last search warrant, I had better not ask.
Now
you get
though.
You're
denying it. You're like, that else has got me figured out. Yep. Tell me how it's not true. You proved, tell me how it's not true. Okay. I could pull an Obama on you. Show me your birth certificate. Back to the case. Yep. That's the case right there. That's what's going on here. I think he is. You're laughing, but. Okay, I'm coming closer here. Because that turns red. That will now turn blue. Okay, I'm coming closer. I believe he's guilty out of bitterness, albeit. So I'm gonna keep on trying to prove this here. I'm coming closer to it. Yep, blue. Here it is, here it is. Come on, show it to me. Nope. I think there are plenty of automatons in Albedo's house, if you remember. I can't prove it still. Oh, what changed? What changed? What changed? Why is it red suddenly? What changed? Oh. They're saying he's using his son? Maybe because he can't move around himself, he's putting his son into... No. So Cassie, were you born in like a British colony somewhere? And like moved to America? Like, are you like the last surviving family, like a British royal family, something like a freaking, like a colony, royal family and everything, but you had to move to America because there's some kind of coup d'etat, alright? And so now you're just hiding away in America until you can return to your country and conquer it again? Is that what's going on? Okay, that's not working out for me. Let's try proving that Sir Charles... No. Let's try proving that... Well, I mean, it's almost like... Sir Charles is the only... Oh! Wow, this is impossible. Nothing's working out for me here. What happened in this story? Who did it? Somebody tried to kill him. Could not have been him. People were trying to kill Albedo. They all think the freak. I mean, we saw Automaton How could he have? Maybe he was lying. I always get that conclusion right there. Strength. A strong person did it. There's no automaton. And there's no automaton. A false statement. Yeah, I know. It could have been him because he's too like a Shaolin monk. Oh, new conclusion. That's what I wanted. That's all I was trying to prove. Albia is guilty. Because he's bitter. Suspect is small, like him, because he is kind of small, isn't he? Is Albeit small? Let me see. Is Albeit small? Albeit is around 45 years old. He is an archaeologist and active member of the Seas Brotherhood. Guy does not seem to be anything near. I mean, disease and everything. They're saying Albia is strong enough. This doesn't make much sense either. But, that's what it says. See, this is what I thought. Yeah, this is what I thought. Albeit uses an adult of small stature as the killer, as he wishes people to believe that the curse killed Zacharias Greystoke, and at a later date other members of the expedition. Yeah, this is what I believe. I think he uses somebody. Exactly. Okay, exactly. So now that we're here, and come to this conclusion, now it comes to the conclusion, okay? Let's come to another conclusion. Alright, where were you born? Where were you born, Cassandra? Where were you born? I know you're laughing. You're probably not laughing anymore. You're like, okay, Alex, bad joke. Joke's over. Alright, anyway. Who's texting me? Alright. So, this is what I think happened. I think he is bitter. Is using a small person to do his duty, do his job, and yes. You're laughing. You are laughing. However, we can prove it all. Okay? I'm gonna text you proof. Watch this. Boom. There it is. I know your heart is beating fast right now. Your heart just went boom, boom, boom. I know. Test me back. Test me back. Uh-huh. Ignore my text now, huh? Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Boom. There's my theory about you. Alright, anyway. Let's see. What about Sherlock? What about Sherlock? What Alec? What Scotty? Let's see. Yeah, that's what I believe happening. He's using an adult of small stature as a killer. Okay. This person of small stature can fit inside these little machines, okay? Using the strength of the automatons. That's what I believe is going on here. Yes. Here we go. X. I'm pressing X. Check out my text first. I'm gonna get some food too. I'm hungry. Hold on, I need some food before I press X. All right, here we go.
There we go.
All right, here we go. Condemn him. Yes. This is the only thing I can conclude right here. And he's using the automatons. Yes, correct.
Oh, you're here with your son.
Yes, obviously.
We have to talk with you, and it involves the police.
I see. Gulliver, go across the road to Mrs. James. This is an adult conversation.
Hold on just one second, please.
Stay here. Whoa!
A pygmy?
As I suspected. Albeit brought him back from Brazil. You were both slaves there and you escaped together, am I correct?
You are. We are companions through life to death. He's more like a brother to me.
It's clear enough now. You and your accomplice are guilty to the murder of Zacharias Greystone.
They had to pay for what they did.
If I got it.
I've had the time to get all of them. But Gulliver only did what I told him.
It's for the judge to decide that. But given the nature of judges, I doubt that he will be lenient towards a pygmy who kills an Englishman.
Wow. Wow, but okay. That pygmy can't die. I'm sorry. That pygmy should not die. So I'm gonna change that. That pygmy was probably an innocent boy just brought here just to do whatever that man said. So I think I'm gonna let that pygmy go free. Wouldn't you agree? That pygmy shouldn't go to no British jail. In the British court. The Sherlock is white. Sherlock is right. These white people are not to let, these white folks will not let black dude go. Cause see, let's go that route. He's gonna die soon anyway. Yeah, exactly. He's gonna die soon anyway. His short accomplice was used as a live weapon. They should be allowed to remain free. Only if I could watch them both, though. Let's see. Let's see what happens here.
Mr. Albeit. Oh, you're here with your son.
Yes, obviously.
We have to talk with you, and it involves the police.
I see. Gulliver, go across the road to Mrs. James. This is an adult conversation.
Hold on just one second, please.
A pygmy?
As I suspected. Albeit brought him back from Brazil. You were both slaves there and you escaped together, am I correct?
You are. We are companions through life to death. He's more like a brother to me.
So he's the murderer?
But he was merely obeying his master.
Yes, I'm the one who planned the murder. I'm the one responsible.
You wanted them to pay for what they did to you.
True. Now I don't care what happens to me. I'll be dead soon. But Gulliver, you have to let him go.
I wasn't planning to arrest you, only that we might know the truth. Although I regret that Gulliver must leave England and return to his own country.
Shame. But thank you, Mr. Holmes.
Yeah. That's the best way. But now, out of pure curiosity, can I find a different ending? Let's see. Just out of pure curiosity. I mean, we'll go with that one. It's not totally proper, honestly. But, I just can't, that pygmy, I cannot see that pygmy in the court of law. No way. He'll get destroyed by the British, man. It's wrong. Let's, just for the sake of things, try to find a different ending here. I'm not sure how to prove another one. Trying to prove him being guilty, huh? I would totally ignore that proper way. See, it is an ultimate time. There is a running statue. Son is innocent. Boom! That's the other one. Okay. The witness. Sir Charles saw Bernard Marley all over town running away. Exactly. On the morning of the murder. That's the other option right here. So let's prove Charles Marley did it. Huh? So he saw it happening, albeit. Okay, hold on. He's the witness. He saw it happening. He's not bitter, no revenge. Boom, there it is. Boom. Let's try to hope Bernard Marley is guilty thing. Honestly, here's the thing. What were the automatons doing? What was the whole automaton thing about? What was the entire thing that he saw? I mean, they're what holding on? Yeah, all right. British colonist, royalty from a different country. Mm-hmm, I got you. Figured you out. Anyway, yeah, Bernard Marley is definitely. This one is, can both be happening at the same time? What happened here? Could machines have done all this stuff right here? Yeah. I mean, the whole thing with the leaves, the thing getting up and leaving, the robots they were able to shoot. And what were we looking at here? But, a pygmy could, is strong enough. Okay. A pygmy could do all those things. Could dress up as a machine. Catch a strong throw. You know, the pygmies. Well, let's check this out.
What's happened? Did someone else die? Did Tekunuman strike again?
No, which you know very well. Because you are the killer arm of this so-called curse.
Me? No, I'm not. I don't believe in any of that rubbish.
I have no choice but to hand you over to the justice, Mr. Marley.
Okay. Obviously the wrong ending. Yeah. I still don't quite get how the Brazilian, yeah, the pygmy, I don't get it. So confused by that though. What did he see? Maybe it was his imagination, you know? All the rest of the stuff was a red herring. It was just imagination. Alright, conclusions. Well, we've done it. I think I did. With your help, thank you.
Mr. Albeit. Oh, you're here with your son.
Yes, obviously.
We have to talk with you, and it involves the police.
I see. Gulliver, go across the road to Mrs. James. This is an adult conversation.
Hold on just one second, please. A pygmy? As I suspected.
This mission was very, very difficult. And prison. Guess what? I did not cheat one time. And you escaped together. I didn't go online one time. I didn't cheat one time. Did everything by myself.
Companions through life to death. He's more like a brother to me.
I'm proud of myself.
So he's the murderer. But he was merely obeying his master.
Yes, I'm the one who planned the murder. I'm the one responsible.
You wanted them to pay for what they did to you.
True. Now I don't care what happens to me. I'll be dead soon. But Gulliver, you have to let him go.
I wasn't planning to arrest you, only that we might know the truth. Although I regret that Gulliver must leave England and return to his own country.
Shame, but thank you, Mr. Holmes.
Okay. Mission complete. Boom! Got a trophy. I must be right. Yeah. Oof, man, that was tough. What's next? And we're gonna hear more about your evil twin, too.
Mr. Orson Wilde is here, and I'm going to stay with Miss Alice.
What?
Did you forget? Orson Wilde, you know, the star of American theatre. And he's visiting and staying with us. You did forget?
No, not that. I meant you wanting to stay with Miss Alice.
Yes, that's exactly right. Miss Alice suggested it. She told me you couldn't possibly refuse.
Mm-hmm. I don't trust her! Well, what do I do here? Oh, man. No, I don't trust Alice. No! No, I'm not doing it. I gotta be a proper father. I'm not gonna let this happen.
Why don't you stay with Mrs. Hudson?
Oh, but Miss Caitlin has more in common with Miss Alice, and they get along so well.
Guess what, Mrs. Hudson? Mr. Wilde is here to study my father's character for his next play. And he won't be disappointed, will he? Father is so pig-headed.
I can't believe it. The great Sherlock Holmes standing in front of me. I'm sure that our two brains will.
Brains.
Oh boy, who's this clown? Who is this clown? Huh. his own boots. Oh boy. Got it. I got everything right. Boom. Orson Wilde, not 30 years of age, is a star of American theater who came to London to study the role of Sherlock Holmes. It is probable that he began his study previously. He smoked the same brand of tobacco as Holmes. Orson is narcissistic and follows fashion. He admires his own reflection. The brooch pinned to his breast displays his American pride.
Mr. Wilde, your room.
Charming. This is such a fascinating city.
We need to talk.
I'd rather not. You're going to be angry again. Goodbye, Mr. Wilde.
It's a bad father.
Is it 5 o'clock already? I think I might go and ask Mrs. Hudson for some tea.
Oh, boy. Yes, Mr. Wilde. Wear that all day. Let's rock that today, my friends. Let's rock that today. Dapper. Orson Wilde. Yeah, the woman is evil. And sure
it would be better to examine Wilde's belongings before he returns. Oh, Wilde's already making himself at home.
Sherlock means Sherlock.
Wilde truly has a perfect disguise kit. Do actors really need all this?
A dude with a makeup box? Okay. Oh, what?
I use the same brushes for makeup.
Oh, okay. They both wear makeup. What kind of men are these?
Face powder of an excellent quality. This must be grease paint.
Sherlock, get out of there.
I forgot my hat. Father?
I'm just checking,
You've got something on your face. Is it makeup?
It might be. Practicing my disguises, you know me. No, don't touch that!
No, no!
Ah, Mrs. Hudson. With our tea.
Not quite. We have a visitor. However, the lady is not so much angry as perplexed.
Good day to you, gentlemen. My name is Mary Sutherland.
I have come to you, Mr. Holmes, because I would give everything I have to know what has become of Mr. Hosmer Angel.
Why the haste, Miss Southern?
Mr. Hosmer Angel has disappeared, and my father, Mr. Winterbank, will do nothing. It makes me so angry.
She got a busted nose, I think. Look at her nose, yo. Her nose bridge. Yeah. Dirt. Oh, okay, now she wears spectacles. Never mind. A brooch. It's an engagement ring today. Oh, whoa, Miss Pat's shoes. Huh. Lila is a good-tempered young lady, 25 years of age. She has poor eyesight. She has failed to notice that she is wearing mismatched boots. Mary's wealthy young lady. She's engaged to be married. Yeah, I think so. So yeah, I'm doing good in this thing so far. I'm this thing.
Mr. Windybank is your stepfather, surely, since the name is different?
Well, indeed, I call him father, although he is barely older than myself.
And your mother is alive?
Oh, yes. Although I wasn't best pleased when she married again, and so soon after father's death, and to a man so much younger than herself.
Those are old school glasses. Even when I was younger, glasses were that way. My glasses are a lot better now, but even when I was a little kid, glasses that I wore would always leave wounds like that. Notice that Wilde is copying Sherlock and all his gestures? It's hilarious.
What is your connection with Mr. Hosmer Angel?
I met
him at the gasfitter's ball. Mr. Winterbank did not wish for me and mother to attend. He never did wish us to go anywhere, but this time I was quite set on it. Fortunately, he left for France upon some business, and so didn't have any say in it. And I met Mr. Angel that night. We met again after that and would take walks together, but then father returned, and we could no longer meet.
Why was your stepfather against your going anywhere?
Well, he didn't like anything of that sort. He used to say that a woman should be happy in her own family circle.
I could say something right now, but I think he'd be very angry at me, so I won't say it. I can say something right now, but I think you would virtually slap me across the face. Anyway.
Did Mr. Hosmer Angel make no attempt to see you?
Well, father was going off again in a week, and Hosmer wrote and said that it would be better for us not to see each other until father had gone. After that, he stopped writing.
Where does Mr. Angel live?
I don't know exactly. I address all of his letters to the Leadenhall Street post office for collection.
Were you engaged?
Oh, yes, Mr. Holmes. Right after the first walk that we took.
What?
Do you have your own income?
I do, from an inheritance. It was left to me by my Uncle Ned in Auckland.
Then you have all that you could wish for, naturally.
Well, I live at home and don't wish to be a burden to my family, so they have the use of the money.
Is there anything else that you can tell me about Mr. Angel?
He is a very shy man. He would rather walk with me in the evening, so as to be discreet. I put a missing persons notice in last Saturday's Chronicle. Here's a copy, and a letter from him.
Ha ha, a love letter. Yes, I see. As I anticipated. This validates my deductions perfectly.
What deductions, Mr.?
Mr. Wilde. Holmes. Tell her. A love letter? Aren't you dying to read it, Holmes?
Okay, so Mr. Angel has a mysterious vanish. Mr. Angel's around 5 feet 7 inches in height. Short guy. A strong build with a sallow complexion. He has black hair with bushy side whiskers and a mustache. He's likely to be wearing tinted spectacles. On last sighting, Mr. Angel was dressed in a black silk frock coat, a black waistcoat, and gray hairish tweed trousers. He is known to have been employed in an office in Landau Street. If you are interested in any information, please come forward. They'll be working. Okay. My dear love, please don't worry your sweet head. Do you believe that I would say anything to your family? No understanding? Would say nothing of love? We had a wonderful time together, didn't we? My father was in France, such a short time, but it was enough for me to know that you were my life. I want to spend every minute from now on with you. I wish that it were possible. I love you very much, and I am waiting for the moment when your stepfather leaves once more upon his travels, so we can meet again. How's everything? Okay. No.
This is strange. The love letter is typewritten.
Oh, look at that.
Good quality paper, quite smooth. Fairly common ink, nothing special. We had a wonderful time together, didn't we, while your father was in France? I'm waiting for the moment when your stepfather leaves once more. Miss Sutherland only met with Hosmer Angel while the stepfather was absent.
Mm-hmm.
Hosmer Angel decided not to leave his signature. Let's study this letter more closely.
I hope nothing nasty's going on. That the stepfather... I hope nothing nasty's going on, Cassandra. That the stepfather basically dresses up as something else, and then... She doesn't even know who he really... Maybe she's actually dating her stepfather. Tell me that's gross. I mean, his outfit when he's around is pathetic. Big whiskers. The coat he's wearing. Yeah, nasty. Nasty. And tight. Doesn't really have a home. The stepdad's in love with his own stepdaughter. Nastiness.
There are some letters with typographical defects. Miss Sutherland, do you have any other letters from Mr. Angel?
Unfortunately not. But I've brought my father's letter from Paris. Here it is.
Oh, goodness gracious me. This could be gross.
The stepfather's letter is also typewritten.
Oh no, I don't want to see this. This could be nasty. I would have figured it out. This could be disgusting. Same?
Quite common paper with a light yellow tint.
Oh, common paper though.
Fairly common ink, nothing special. I hope that you'll be a leading girl. Take my advice, stay at home.
Okay, I take the opportunity of sending you these few lines in the hope that they find you and mother in good faith. France is a nice country to look at, but it is the same as anywhere. There are rogues here who deceive and mistreat their women. Men nowadays are dishonorable. They won't think twice to break your heart. I think this could be gross. This could be an overprotective father protecting the daughter by making sure that she's always with him. Ew. Hope you'll be an obedient girl, see? I look after your mother, and that you will take my advice. Stay at home. I'll be back before long.
Miss Sutherland's stepfather's signature. Stepfather is trying to keep the daughter at home. Let's study this letter more closely.
This could be gross. Oh, boy.
There are some letters with typographical defects. Both letters have typographical defects. They merit further attention.
I'm nervous right now. I want to be wrong. I want to be so wrong right now, okay? The picture of him? There's no picture of him. It's only a description of him. There's no picture.
This letter has a defect. One more letter with a defect. Ah, And it's the same letter, with the same defect in both instances.
This is disgusting. The old typewriter defect situation. Man, I would have solved...
Another letter match with the same defects.
I would have solved a lot of crimes in these days, typewriters.
One more letter with a defect. One more letter with a defect.
He's dressed up. The father is dressed up as the poor girl. She's about to be heartbroken. He's a liar. Man, I hope it wasn't kissing or anything like that, dude. Again, it's a stepfather, so not related, so it's not, you know, completely incest, but... Oh, guys, this is gross. Still, it's disgusting. But, of course, it happened in the Bible. This happened in the Bible. Not that it's not, no tricking, but a father was a stepmother in Corinthians. Hey, stuff happens. Grossness. I can't find any more. Let's see. Try to find some more defects here. More defects? Try to find some more. Find more?
One more letter with a defect.
What do you mean?
One more letter with a defect. One more.
Okay, what else? I thought I found everything here. Yeah, I'm looking, but I can't find... I'm missing something here.
So, based on the specific defects, we could say that these letters were composed on the same typewriter.
Uh-oh. Nasty conclusions I must draw right now. Oh, boy. Alright. That's inclusions. Yep. Letters have the same typewriter defects written by one person on a single typewriter. It's called an overprotective father. Stepfather. Let's see. Exactly. Secretive. Of a goofy girl. See, she's a goofy girl, not aware of herself. Different color boots, the glasses thing on her eyes. She's a goofy girl who would fall for such things. Oh, she has bad eyesight. That fits it. She's not goofy. She's got bad eyesight. That means she can't really tell who the man is. It's her own father, stepfather. See, With Mary Sutherland's uncle gave her an inheritance, she has granted her family the use of money as long as she lives with them. It's kind of... yeah, controlling, stay at home. Yes, the family have an interest in Mary remaining single. Gross! Disgusting! Ew! They made up... they created a... Ew! Oh, nasty! So here's what happened. Hold on. Here's what happened, okay? Basically, money is wrapped up in her staying single. They don't want her leaving the household and have that money go somewhere. She does wear, yeah, she does not wear her glasses. Anyway, so, naturally, as all women do, she want to be with somebody, okay? And so, she fell in love. But with the father dead, to make sure the money stays in the family, he created a person for her to fall in love with. Fake post office. So that she would never leave the household. And now he is quote unquote missing, found Sherlock, and Sherlock's going to bust this thing wide open. Boom. Boom. Mary had the opportunity to socialize without some kind of knowledge. Mary's stepfather lied. He didn't take his business trip. He had found out. No. Mary's stepfather took his business trip, which gave Mary, no, this is it. He had found out that Mary. No. Mary. He didn't take his business trip, as he had found out that Mary was obeying him. Mary's stepfather took his business trip, which gave Mary an opportunity. Yeah, but. Boom. The crooked Hosmer Angel. Mr. Hosmer Angel was a crook who was hired by Mr. Winback. No, I don't believe that. I don't believe this. This is the same person. Hosmer Angel even exists. So, hold on. That's not it. There it is. Mr. Windebake is Mr. Angel. Mary's stepfather, Mr. Windebake, adopted disguise and played the role of Mr. Hosmer Angel, the cute stepfather. And went close to him. Oh my goodness, disgusting. Hide the truth and tell the truth. I gotta tell the truth. I gotta tell the truth. Here we go.
You should try to let Mr. Hosmer Angel vanish from your memory, as he has done from your life.
Then you don't think I'll see him again?
I fear not.
Then what has happened to him?
Your stepfather married your mother for her money, and also enjoyed the use of your income. But with your personal advantages, it was clear that you would not remain single for long, even with him keeping you at home. He disguised himself and reappeared as Mr. Hosmer Angel. He brought you as far as the church door and then conveniently slipped away to bring you to this conclusion in such a dramatic manner that it would leave a permanent impression upon your mind. You have been cruelly tricked, Miss Sutherland.
Oh, Mr. Holmes. No, I can't believe it. But we were engaged. Oh, it's horrible to think about. But thank you for all you have done, Mr. Holmes.
Holmes, you could have been more diplomatic.
Wow. Grossness. Poor girl.
What is going on?
Mr. Holmes, is everything all right?
Oh my God. Go back to your flat and stay there with Kate.
Lifetime ticking.
It's ticking.
You don't like much about it, do you? What the?
It's ticking.
That's the right answer. A bomba.
It's ticking.
Oh, come on. Sorry. I keep thinking move away means move away myself.
It's
which I would do. I would leave.
I see wires inside. They could be connected to the cover. I see wires inside. They could be connected to the cover.
I'm gonna die. I'm probably gonna die a few times here, so. Old school bomb. Oh, shoot. Yeah, I'm probably gonna die a few times.
I found some ticking homemade diff from the secret admirer. I have 2 minutes to defuse it.
Are you fucking kidding me?
There are wires attached to the bell and hammer. When the alarm triggers, the bomb will explode. Source of electricity for the detonation. Aha! This solenoid protects the bomb from being easily diffused. If it loses its power supply, it will close contact between the secondary chain wires and the bomb will explode.
Yeah, this is wonderful.
A package with explosive material. There are wires going in and out. It's useless to predict how they might be tangled up inside.
He's all calm.
Whew.
Come on, end. No. All right, here we go. Plunk. Come on!
What happened?
Just a small bomb.
Somebody wants to kill me? What for?
I don't believe that you were the target.
Who then?
Did it!
Mr. Holmes, are you all right? I saw the bloke. I tried to catch him, but he escaped.
Can you describe the man?
He was thin, about 5'5", with black hair and a hair lip.
Wiggins, tell us everything you saw.
The fellow was watching your place, so I thought maybe he's a client. But then he took something out of his jacket and threw it, smashing your window.
Terrorism,
I shouted
man.
At him and he took off. I grabbed him by the sleeve, but he wriggled out of his jacket and left it. I'm sorry I didn't catch him, Mr. Holmes.
You did very well, Wiggins. Now, let's take a look at that jacket.
Here it is.
Good job, Wiggins. Here's a penny.
It is.
Thanks, Mr. Holmes.
You're a coward, man.
Who tried to kill me, Mr. Holmes?
JT are the owner's initials.
I don't know who watch it is.
Let's see what's inside.
There could be a hidden message that's been written with some lemon juice.
Dude!
No, don't touch anything else.
Dude, kick this clown, man.
There are ink stains on this piece of paper. I could read the text with the help of my analysis table if Wilde hadn't already destroyed it. I could read the text with the help of my analysis table if Wilde hadn't already destroyed it.
Clown. Rally Mohawks, bring out your axes, and tell King George he'll pay, he'll pay no taxes on his foreign tea. Oh boy, that's British. That's American stuff right here. It threats our reign. In vain to think to force our girls and wives to drink this vile bohea. Then rally, boys, and hasten on to meet our chief, at Green Dragon. That's old school American Revolution stuff. Mohawks?
A poem. But what does it mean?
This isn't a poem. It's a song called Rally Mohawks. That great moment when America rebelled against England's dominance. Then rally, boys, and hasten on to meet our chiefs at the Green Dragon. And I bet they hoisted a tankard of ale and invented a new nation, along with deciding if this was the week they got to dump some tea into yon harbor.
Why ever did he keep such a song in his pocket?
Exactly. Tried to kill me, eh?
Thanks to Wilde, my analysis table has been completely destroyed.
Sherlock is very patient with a lot of foolishness. There it is, the song. Yep, posing as natives. Old school Google. That's how Google used to be, man. You had to go through things. You couldn't just look stuff up, type in words. Nope.
That's not the one I need. the one I need. Here it is.
Old school Google. You had to work in the old days to get information. Alright, you can remember the public house use of both a tavern and a meeting place that was located on Union Street in Boston's North End. In the early 19th century, a number of replicas of the Green Dragon over across Europe. One of these is now located in London near the harbor. Whitechapel.
That's all I can do for now, is try and get a few hours of sleep.
How can you sleep when there is someone trying to kill me? How selfish.
Don't try to kill you behind, dude. This might be kind of annoying with this guy next to us, unfortunately. Sorry about this, but the game seems to want this guy around. I'm afraid. Change my clothes a bit.
Did he sleep well, Kate?
Very well, thank you, Father.
Is that Wild?
Oh, boy.
Whatever is he doing now?
He's transforming you into a legend.
Oh, silly man. Kate, what's the matter?
Well, I just came by to tell you that I'm going to the zoo with Alice. We'll be having lunch in town.
This Alice person is...
I've hardly seen you these past few days. Don't you want to stay here for a while, Kate?
Did you remember then? It's my birthday today!
Embarrassing. She'll see through my lie.
I'm so sorry, Kate. With Wilde's visit, I... Look, here's some spending money. Go and treat yourself to a thing.
All right. I'll go then.
Kate.
Oh, no.
You never do anything right.
All right. Come here.
I've had enough of you not caring about me.
I do care. I've just had a difficult night.
Yes. A bowing off.
Alice told told me about the bomb, but you wouldn't.
Kate, I only want to protect you.
You don't understand anything. I wish Alice would adopt me.
Don't be ridiculous.
I don't know why my parents entrusted me to you. Did they really know you?
Kate, come back. Damn it. Such a waste. This Alice, I have an odd sense about her. It's as if she's playing with Kate's feelings.
Oh, you
this
think?
This would be a good opportunity to investigate Alice's flat while they're absent. And anyway, it'd be better to visit the Green Dragon Tavern during the evening.
Oh, we're gonna find stuff out now. Okay. But hold on. First of all, I'm gonna get some pretzel dip. Yes. Oh, belt time. Yeah, you know how it is. Black folks don't take no drama like that. Okay? My mom be like, excuse you? You think you're on TV? Or you gonna cry, huh? Okay, I'm gonna give you a reason to cry. See, black folks don't do this kind of drama. This is white drama right here. White folks like, you know, oh my god, Alice, no! Not where we from, okay? And obviously not where British colonists do either, because where you're from apparently doesn't happen either. Here we go. We are going to check Alice's flat out. You don't care about me. My mom will be like, excuse you?
Mrs. Hudson is not at home.
That's right, Cherokee woman too, yeah.
A back room.
Don't talk back to me.
Force is not an option. I should find another way inside Alice's flat. Force is not an option. I should find another way inside Alice's flat.
Here, perhaps. Right? Here? No? Okay. I know how to get to her flat. Easy. Oh, great. Oh, this is wonderful. Yeah, great. I can use several lock picks now, making it more complicated. Yay. Okay, so. Oh, come on. All right, what am I doing wrong here? The first one, I gotta... I gotta get this first one first. Block at everything. Wait, I can add a few. I can add, so let me see if I can add another one real quick. Okay. There we go. Boom. Ready for this? Are you ready for this? Okay, I think what you might see in this house is pretty bad. Just want to clarify. If it offends you, I'm sorry, but it may be witchcraft stuff, I suspect. Here we go.
It appears that Alice sleeps in this armchair, as uncomfortable as that must be. Alice prepared a gift for Kate. She remembered her birthday. Well, women are good at that sort of thing.
This is true. I am bad with birthdays. A vial.
It has no smell. Has a bitter taste. No smell, bitter taste. It's a tincture of barbiturate.
Barbiturate?
A soothing drug to aid sleep.
Exactly. She is your evil twin. I totally imagine you have a room just like this. Dear Miss, thank you for your most recent delivery of shirts for my cousin. They are marvelous. As I told you, this Saturday I shall be attending the wedding breakfast of my dear friends, and they look stunning. Please be sure to finish my dress by 5 to latest. I will send for it in the morning. All right.
Alice has recently used this. Photographs.
Wonderful. Did I rotate it? Hold on. Looks like it's solved already. I'm confused. Is it not already solved? Okay, I'm not quite understanding what I have to do here. Yeah, I'm confused. So I gotta make a pathway from here to there, but it seems to be like it's working already. see? What am I not seeing properly? Hold on, I'll come back to that. I don't quite get what. Look at the Dallas to plot an entire path through the maze in order to open the casket. What am I not getting here? Okay, I got it. Okay, so. Very difficult, but I got it. Very difficult. Keep insane. Okay, that works. Through here. Through there, up around there, through there, through there. That works. Go through here, boom. Okay, how does it work? So. Over here. This is, wow. Yeah. Through there, through here, down through there, around there, on there, through there, yep. Then through here, okay. Got it. My dear little Alice, if you read this letter, when it means that I'm no longer in this world, what? My illness had defeated me. Please try not to be sad, dear, for I have lived a good life. The only regret is that you are now alone. You will be sent to live with a who knows what who, an unknown family. I do not trust the institutions. You behave so cruelly toward your father. Please take care of my dear Aunt Angel. You know the secret to which allow you to speak with souls of the dead. Whoa, uh-oh. You know the secret which allow you to speak with the souls of the dead? So you may talk soon. Oh boy.
Alice's childhood was spent with her aunt until the aunt's death.
Dear, thinking of you now has made me remember the past. And as you well know, I was always a worrier. Every time that you were sent to live with another family, I hope you will be happy. People are cruel, aren't they? The angers me that you think of you. So it was about every home to be considered home to servant rather than a member of the family. You suffer so much, but I am happy now to congratulate you on your 23rd birthday. Now all your horrors are behind you. You are a grown, independent, new woman. I wish you the life that you deserve, Anna.
Alice was unhappy with all of her adopted families.
This is why she feels sorry for Sherlock's daughter, perhaps, or something. Oh, he wakes early despite the fact that the lamp in his room glows into the small hours. He invites a street urchin with a squirt and put his name William. Trinidad Watson is always nearby. It seems very close. He's suspected by inspectors throughout, though he never works with police. Katie is so sweet and honest and hated, but he doesn't spend no time in town. Okay.
She's spying.
Yep. Got it.
It looks as though Alice has not slept here for a long time. It appears that Alice sleeps in this...
Okay, well. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. This looks... a bit scary. There it is. Oh boy.
Sarah de Bouvier is Alice's mother.
Sarah de Bouvier? This is voodoo stuff right here. This girl's from Jamaica. No, from Haiti.
Sarah de Bouvier is Alice's
mother. Sarah de Bouvier, that's Haitian. See?
Strange taste in literature.
I'd say.
Her full name is Alice Floella Hamilton.
Of course she's mixed. Look at her face. Told you, you're twin. Can you tell by her, like, you couldn't tell by her face she was mixed? I want to inform you that your rental franchise has been prepared. You can contact it whenever you're convenient, any evening of the week. Mrs. Hudson, landlady. Yeah, Mr. de Bouvier. Okay.
Alice, you to lease the flat.
Oh.
Kate probably sleeps here.
Look at the wind, look at the mirror, broken. No. No, Kate is daughter's name. Look. Alice is a twin. Kate is daughter. Come on. Cassandra. Oh, come on, British Islander. No way Kate is mixed. That girl's white as a chalk.
Kate probably sleeps here. This lock is quite new.
Okay, this room may be really bad. Just warning you. I think I know what's in this room.
Oh my god.
Okay, I'm nervous. If you want, you can leave. I understand. I'm not afraid of this stuff, and the game portrays it as evil, so I don't care.
The wheelchair is the same as the one in the photograph above. Louis Napoleon Bonaparte. It's my distant ancestor, Horace Vernon.
What?
William Hamilton. But I know him. He was a bandit who I arrested 20 years ago.
She is evil as heck.
Alice is talking with her father, William Hamilton.
What? Zacharias Greystoke?
Alice knows about Zacharias Greystoke, the victim from the bowling club. I solved that crime. Alice knows about Zacharias Greystoke, the victim from the bowling club. I solved that crime.
This is freaky. beyond strange. Corrupted. Advises 27 people, including 4 children that have been discovered in southwest Spain. Deceased, remembers of the veneration of the dam, had consumed a soft drink laced with deadly cyanide and sedatives. Police were only able to save one young woman, Alice Florella of Hamilton. The lady, who was unharmed yet in deep shock, remains unable to shed any light on the case. Oh. She only one survived, and that she's from a cult. Gotcha. A nasty cult. Only survivor. She's jacked up. She's,
Charles Darwin, English naturalist and geologist.
Yeah, of course you'd be involved with Charles Darwin.
Abraham Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln?
My word, look at this setup. Alice practically. I finished here, time to go.
Yeah, let's get out of here. I don't want to be in this place again. It's their own minds.
It's shut tight.
Get it out of here, man.
I need to change my clothes.
Let us get out of here.
I cannot proceed dressed like that.
How am I to be dressed? Yeah, seriously. How am I to be dressed? How am I dressed? Like that? Okay, I guess that works. Well, I'm gonna leave pretty soon. My Mets are gonna play in a few minutes, and I wanna watch my baseball. So, let me do a little bit more. And then what, my New York Mets? I'm a Mets fan. You gotta win. Yeah, I agree. We need it.
I have to be careful in this den of iniquity.
Come on, Bobby, push back.
Hey, you, shut up.
Well done, Tuffin's Bobby.
Tuffin's on Adam.
I put a penny on Adam winning.
Bobby, I just put 5 pence on you.
Hey, you, shut up.
Well done, Bobby.
Adam, come on, you're going to win.
Bit of an issue with your friends.
Hey, shut up.
Well done, Bobby.
This place of evil. this cabal of filth.
I should be quiet so that I can listen to what people are saying. There's no one to eavesdrop
Let's
on from
celebrate.
Me.
Sod off.
Sod off. No.
I've lost too much here. Damn poker.
There's an illegal gambling den.
Let's celebrate.
I can hear nothing from here. I can hear nothing from here.
I drink to forget that I drink.
Yeah.
Damn. The attack alone has failed.
What? Sorry for the bad language.
Interesting. They have some kind of pass for getting inside.
I drink to forget that I drink. Bottoms up.
Hey, Mughunter, what do you think you're doing? Get out of here!
Cheers!
Bottoms up.
I need a refill!
Let's celebrate!
Come on! Ah! Well, it's hard. Come on. Come on.
Remember the airlift? He was afraid. He ran upstairs.
But I got skills.
Man with a head. He could be my attacker. I should find a way to go upstairs.
Let's celebrate.
Cheers.
Bottoms up.
Want a beer?
Let's celebrate.
I'll drink
Get out of it.
I'll drink. Bottoms up.
Scotland Yard dogs!
Hey, this is my table.
Let's celebrate.
Cheers!
Bottoms up.
I need a refill.
Let's celebrate.
I drink to forget that I drink. Bottoms up.
Scotland Yard dogs! Sod off. Let's celebrate.
Well.
Bottoms up.
Let's celebrate.
I drink to forget that I drink. Bottoms up.
I I can hear nothing from here.
Ah, come on, Sherlock.
Drink to forget that I drink. Bottoms up.
Celebrate. Cheers.
Bottoms up.
Yeah, done.
I need a refill.
Let's celebrate.
Ah! Come on.
Good beer. Strong.
Let's celebrate.
Perhaps I should try it.
Hey, what are you looking for? Get lost.
I drink to forget that I drink.
Get out of here! Scotland Yard dogs!
I'm trying to get a beer now. I can't get a beer.
Want a beer?
Let's celebrate.
Want a beer?
Yeah.
Pour me a double. I'm going outside for a cigarette.
There's a pass. I could steal it to gain entry.
Come on, Sherlock. Oh boy, Sherlock. Don't mess up. Oh my goodness, this is hard. Ah!
Huh?
Crap! Sherlock, honestly, this is really hard. Come on, Sherlock, you can do it. Ah! Oh my goodness, this is wow. This is uniquely difficult. I've never had this before in a game. No. Okay, come on, do this. Wow. Ugh. Okay, I gotta go. Alright, you might be where I'm at. Hold on, if I can get in that room then, see.
You can get in. Right.
Cheers!
Bottoms up.
Here, look.
Is the boss at his place?
Yeah, he's waiting for you.
A man. I should find a way to follow him.
Okay. Oh, that was fun. Better than last time. Okay. I'm off to watch the VFX. Oh, And, yeah. You, take care of your British self, okay? Alright. Bye.